you hear? Are we clear? Clear for liftoff. Take off. For making reverberations. Are we affirmative? No negatory. Come in, come in. Radio, what's your story? Ayahuasca kilo. Will you welcome? Are you ready for a better Echo Victor? Feeling wider than awake. Yeah. Better quicken than straight.
And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. We've got a perfect night for baseball on the show. It's the Arizona Diamondbacks going up against the Atlanta Braves. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. So almost ready to get underway. And on the hill in this one, Kyle Wright.
Well, he's been a real quality starter for his club. And coming into this one, what stands out for me is that right-handed hitters have really struggled batting below 200 on the year. It seems they have a hard time picking up his release point and tracking the ball into the zone. So we'll see how right-handers do against him in this one.
Josh Rojas at the plate now. Looks at one down below the zone.
First pitch. 720.
The next offering misses. 2-0.
2-0.
On the ground, right side. Boots it. Save!
Oh, he's safe.
Pretty much gifted a leadoff base runner right there. And as an offense, this is where you really want to take advantage. Apply some pressure this inning. Make that error hurt.
Alec Thomas now looking for his first big league hit right here.
He's going.
Here's the pitch. Runner on the goal. Swing and a miss. Safe at second, and he easily steals the bag.
Well, he's batting leadoff, and he's acting like a traditional leadoff hitter. Gets on base to start the game, then puts himself on second with a nice stolen bag. I think that sets the tone for the offense for sure.
Now the 0-1. Foul ball there. Runner at second, nobody out. Swings and lines a base hit into left field, and they get it in quickly. First and third now with nobody out. Alec Thomas with his first major league hit, and this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. A guy works so hard and has to wait so long for this to happen, and when it does, it can kind of be overwhelming, Boog. You still have to stay locked in on the game, but it's great when you could take a minute to just appreciate what you've done and how hard you've worked to get here.
Ketel Marte up to the plate. That one's in there, 0-1. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. Way back there. That one is gone. Cattell Marte goes deep. His first homer of the year. It's 3-0.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
And now it's Christian Walker.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, Christian.
It can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
The pitch. And it's even up. The pitch. Hard ground ball, base knock.
Batting fifth.
David Peralta at the plate.
David Peralta.
And that's in there for strike one. Walker gets his lead at first. Nobody out.
Oh, I'm feeling good about this one.
Wait. Swing and a hard hit liner up the middle to base hit. Lead runner to second. So two on and nobody out.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
And now it's Dalton Varsho. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Singy, maybe some nerves getting the best of him in the first?
Well, it's hard to know exactly if it's nerves or not, but he just doesn't have it right now. Those hitters on the other side, they're going to say it's nerves and use that as a competitive edge to try to jump on him even more.
And a 1-0. And that's downstairs and outside. Next offering is in for a strike. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
Next one misses. And a count is 3-1. The pitch. Now front, pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2. No outs, runners at first and second. That's a hit. They won't test it here. Bases loaded, no outs.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
McCarthy.
Jake McCarthy will hit next. Grounder might be two. Can't glove it cleanly. He comes home with it. And he'll be safe at first.
That's what a good sinker's designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
And now the batter is Carson Kelly. First offering is fouled off.
Well, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
Next offering is in for a strike.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
And here it comes. lined into right. Base hit. One run is in. And they hold the runner at third. Bases remain loaded here. Still only one gone.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Pitch was away, and he did exactly what you're supposed to do with it. Drive it the other way. Just go with the pitch.
So the bases are loaded here. One man gone. Geraldo Perdomo stands in now for the Diamondbacks. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Well, it's not the inning he was planning on to begin this start, but you've got to find a way to shake things off and give your team some length and put up some zeros.
And the right-hander deals. Just missed.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count. Base is loaded. You don't want to fall to a three-ball count and then walk in a run. He's got to challenge the hitter right here.
In the dirt, blocked. Nothing happening on the bases, though. That is ball four, and that'll bring home a run.
He's really gotten himself into a mess out there and now forces home a run with the walk. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
Here comes the manager out of the Braves dugout, and he will make a move to the pen. Kyle Wright will depart, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. So they turn things over to the righty, number 53. The bases are loaded, so no time to settle into this. Here's Josh Rojas. In there, and it's 0-1.
Tough situation right here. So important as a pitcher to get ahead in the count as he did right there.
Base hit, one run in already. Runner at third puts on the brakes. Bases still loaded and still only one away.
With the bases juiced, he refused to get pull happy. He stayed within himself, drove the ball to center field. That'll get across a run.
Here's a speed threat, Alec Thomas. And that one is lifted in the air. Acuna there. And makes the grab. Runner tags from third. Cut off. Now a throw home. In there. He scores. And they're pulling away up by seven now.
Now batting. Second baseman. Ketel Marte.
Here's Ketel Marte.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, you know, maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
And the pitch.
Nope, that's a ball.
Good spot for the hitter. Nope, definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
And he deals. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Next offering misses, full count now. In the air, left side, Rosario under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Bottom half of inning number one coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 7 and the Braves nothing. They go to the bottom of the first. And on the hill in this one, Madison Bumgarner. What do we need to know here?
He's been a very solid pitcher throughout his career. ERA around 3.5. What I like is he competes, he stays in the game, and he gives his team an opportunity to win.
Bottom of the first, and here is Ronald Acuna Jr. You talk about the power and the speed together.
Well, we knew he was going to be a stud just coming up, making his way through the minor leagues and quickly at this level, an impact player.
McCarthy sizing this one up, and it's caught for the out. Here's Brian Snitker's lineup for the Braves. Ziggy, this lineup has the benefit of playing behind a great pitching staff. They've got a really low ERA.
Yeah, and, you know, with that said, there's not as much pressure on the offense. But make no mistake about it. Guys want to hit the ball hard, and they want to score runs. They want to jog around the bases, hitting the ball over the fence. So regardless of how dominant the staff can be, the attitude is we want to go out there and have some fun with the bat. So we'll see. One big inning in this one, you know, could be all they need, but you'd like to have multiple big innings.
The next pitch misses. Two balls, no strikes, the count. Mad Bum deals. That one missed, now 3-0.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but batting now third. At least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Here's Austin Riley. In there for strike one. And the pitch. Hit well. Right field, way back, and gone. Austin Riley goes deep. His first homer of the year, and they slice into the lead. It's 7-2.
Of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
One out, base is empty. And now it's Travis d'Arnaud with the plate.
Batting fourth, the catcher, Travis.
And there's a hit. So they get a man aboard with a one out single.
All over that one right there. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
One gone, runner at first. Now in for the Braves, Matt Olson. First offering misses the mark. The lefty, the 1-0. Swings through that.
Just started in and ended up on the outside edge. Just changing planes and very difficult, especially for a left-handed hitter to track.
The next offering misses. Two balls and a strike. Left-handed hitter waits. That one ripped. And one hops off the wall. Should be extra bases.
A little more backspin on that instead of the top spin. And he's jogging around the bases rather than pulling up at second.
So, man aboard. Here's Marcell Ozuna.
Batting fifth. The designated hitter, Marcell Ozuna.
And that one lifted in the air center field. McCarthy moving under it. And there are two outs.
Batting seven, the left fielder, Eddie.
Here's Eddie Rosario. That one's in there, 0-1.
When you're struggling out there on the mound, hitters know that there'll be plenty of opportunities within the at-bat to try to get something to hit hard.
The pitch. That one hammered left field. That's back there. That's going. And it is gone. A shot to left. His first homer of the year, and they cut into the lead. It's 7-5.
Drive, saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ballgame.
Here's Orlando Arcia.
Batting it, the second baseman.
That one Orlando. Out to right.
Arcia.
And it jumps the wall in foul territory for an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next guy to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
Batting nine.
And it's scoring position with two away. Michael Harris digs in now. Pitch misses inside, and it's 1-0.
Well, clear game plan coming in this one. Be aggressive against this starter. Try to knock him out of this ball game, and it looks like they're on their way to doing that. Get into the bullpen a little bit early. Could be a great offensive day.
Next one misses. Yeah, that's ball two.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Swings and misses. Now 2-1. And now the lefty. And another ball. Arcia stands at second with two gone. And that's ball four.
The right fielder.
Back to the
13.
Top of the lineup. And now it's Ronald Acuna Jr. Flied out his first time. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
Hit on the ground to the right side. The flip to the pitcher covering. And Acuna retires. And that ends the inning. I tell you what, I think we all just jumped across that. Top of the second, stepping in the long ball threat, Christian Walker.
Leading off for Arizona, the first baseman, Christian Walker.
Hawaii to kick the pitch. And takes low for ball one.
Count 1-0.
Here comes a pitch. And now 2-0. Ed Drummond behind the plate calling balls and strikes. Maybe one of the most respected umpires around the league.
He's not the kind of umpire that you're likely to notice back there. And that can be a huge compliment, really. So if you're just kind of quietly doing your job, staying consistent with your calls, hitters, pitchers, managers, even fans, they're all going to appreciate you. Ed Drummond, he's that kind of umpire.
Righty delivers. That one's in there. And that's strike one. And now a full count. Stays alive. A wind and a pitch. In the air, center field. Harris settles under this one. And there's one away.
Now batting, the left fielder, David Peralta.
So up next, David Peralta singled and scored his first time. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
One down, base is empty.
Ball, that pitch is out.
That one misses, and that's ball three. Kicks and deals. And that's through there for a strike.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
And a foul ball left side. And the righty deals. Line drive. And Acuna able to make the grab. And there's two down.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it. But sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. Looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
Dalton Varsho, the next to hit. One for one with a single and a run scored so far. Oh, now this is drilled to center. Way back there. On its way and gone. His first homer of the year, and they add a run. It's 8-5.
With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Jake McCarthy stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Now batting, the center fielder, Jake.
First pitch, and McCarthy. He just misses. Right-handed reliever. That misses, and it's
2-0.
Two down, nobody on. And it is 2-1. That one fouled off. Next pitch inside, and it's 3-2. Two outs. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And a pitch. Got him looking. Down on strikes, and he knew it. D-backs get one on the solo jack. It's now 8-5. We head to the bottom of the second. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Dansby Swanson.
Swanson, former first-round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff, but really coming into his own.
On the ground to third. Throws across the diamond, and Swanson is set down.
Now batting, the third baseman, Austin Riley.
So digging in, Austin Riley. He's already homered in this one. Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball one. That one missing inside. Singy, he wasn't real sharp in the first, got hit around, but really more so, didn't throw a ton of strikes.
Well, he's just got to find a way to settle down. He was clearly fighting himself out there, not really finding the strike zone, walking batters. So we'll see if he can get back on track and fill up the zone a little bit more.
Next offering is foul back. The wind of the pitch. One fouled off, 2-2. And a pitch. Stays alive. Up the middle. Gets it to first. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two.
The bat. The catcher. Travis Darno.
Two outs, bases empty. Travis Darno next up for the Braves. That hits the dirt. Ball one. The wind of the pitch. There's a strike.
It's a good changeup to hit up in the zone. I don't think he recognized it. I'm sure he'd love to have that one back.
Bounced out to short. Perdomo on to first. And that will end the inning. Back at Truist Park, all set for the start of the inning. Now the D-backs catcher, Carson Kelly.
The catcher, Carson Kelly.
The pitch. Ball one there. Movement in the bullpen. Jesse Chavez up and throwing. Pitch.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. Right-hander kicks, deals. Smoked on the ground a second. Arcia whips it to first. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
The batter, number two, shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo.
stepping in as the switch hitting shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Makes the catch. Out number two.
Now batting, the third baseman, Josh.
So the batting order turns over. Here's the third baseman, Josh Rojas. And he's already singled in this game. And that's in there for strike one. Kicks and fires. And that one fouled off. Next offering is down low.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Now fly ball to right center. Harris should have this one. Squeezes it, and that'll do it. And the Diamondbacks down in order. They're on top by 3, 8-5.
Wearing a cape and apron, so I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Do you think that's just a statement? Then you're ludicrous like it's word of mouth. I ain't new to what.
And welcome back as we go to the last of the third. Now in for the Braves, Matt Olson.
The first baseman.
The Braves in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
The pitch. Strike one. And now it's even up. Left hand batter waits. Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. Matt Olson goes deep. His first homer of the year, and they're chipping away. It's 8-6. Let's break out the StatCast numbers. It's Singy. It tells us this home run was projected at more than 450 feet.
Yeah, and not many players can hit home runs as far as this one. That's a special feeling, and I'm sure he was giggling a little bit as he was jogging around the bases. That was one heck of a swing he put on the baseball.
Now batting.
Now here is Marcell Ozuna. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And here it comes. Ball. Oh, now this one blasted deep to left. Way back there on its way and out of here. That fires up the home crowd. His first homer of the year. It's 8-7.
Back jacks, and this club is fired up right now, Boog. This is the kind of thing where you really start to notice hitters in the lineup beating off each other, and the collective confidence just continues to grow.
Here comes the skipper out of the dugout, and he's ready to make the move. Madison Bumgarner will depart. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. Caleb Smith gets the call from the pen, and he'll work on holding this lead.
Number 22, Caleb Smith.
Yeah. Eddie Rosario next up for the Braves.
Up next for Atlanta, the left fielder.
First offering, Eddie. Misses the mark.
Rosario.
Next offering is in for a strike. The 1-1. That one missed. The 2-1. On the ground, right side. Dives, but it kicks off his glove. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. One away. That ground ball may have him back on track after the homer.
Orlando Arcia.
Orlando Arcia getting ready to hit. Doubled in his first AB. Pitch misses inside. Ball one. Still only one out here in the inning. Next offering is in for a strike.
One and one.
This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Walker makes the catch, and there's two away.
Now batting, center fielder, Michael Harris.
Two outs, bases empty. Here's the center fielder, Michael Harris. First offering misses badly for ball one. And there's the strike. The pitch.
One ball, two strikes, the count.
Two balls, two strikes, the count with two outs. Next pitch is downstairs. And now the lefty. Swing and a line drive. Base hit out of the center field. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive. Michael Harris with his first major league hit. And this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. A guy works so hard and has to wait so long for this to happen. And when it does, it kind of be overwhelming, dude. You still have to stay locked in on the game, but it's great when you can take a minute to just appreciate what you've done and how hard you worked to get here.
Here's Acuña now. Runner on the go. It's a pitch out. Throw to second. Out at second. That ends the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. And the home team down a run. Back here in Atlanta, digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Alec Thomas.
The right fielder, number five, Alec.
And the right hitter back to work.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
The 1-0. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Swanson fires over to first. And a quick out number one.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Marte.
An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And the 1-0. Yeah, that's outside.
Out.
fouled off. He was late. 2-1 down. Foul ball. Two, two now. Just missed. Hammer, base hit.
Right there, does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Christian Walker.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Christian Walker, 1-for-2. And a foul ball. Marte, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Next pitch is in the dirt, and the count even 1-1. And a good eye there.
Good miss with that changeup away. He needs a ball on the ground for a double play. Minimize the potential threat right here. On the hitter's side, nice job of laying off that pitch.
Next offering is downstairs. And the pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
And he deals. On the ground to the left. That's a base hit. The throw to third. In there safely.
Up next for the Diamondbacks.
David Peralta stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Peralta.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Runners are at the corners, one away. Next offering is in for a strike. Swings and misses. And a count 1-2. Hard hit on the line. Stretches out and hauls it in. Runner tagging from third. In comes the run from third. And they take a two-run lead.
Now that designated hitter, Dalton Varsho.
Next is the designated hitter, Dalton Varsho. And he grounds one back up the middle. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it to first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
Now that, the seventh.
Next to hit, Jake McCarthy. In the air, left field. And puts the squeeze on that one. And that is the third out of the inning. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the D-backs 9 and the Braves 7. Welcome back. John Chambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Ronald Acuna Jr.
The right fielder, Ronald Acuna Jr.
Smith back to work. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Ronald Acuna Jr., a guy who burst on the scene in 2018. He was only 20 years old, and he is one of the great talents in baseball right now. Next pitch is outside. Next one off the plate inside, and that's ball three. Here comes a pitch. And he walked him.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Dansby Swanson stands in.
That's shortstop. Dansby Swanson.
In there, and it's 0-1. Next offering is in for a strike.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Pickoff throw, and he's back standing. And a pitch. Got him. Now one away.
Well, I think that's a case of overthinking right there. He got three straight now fastballs looking in the 0-2 count. There. Just a poor at bat.
Riley.
Austin Riley next up for the Braves. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next offering misses, and 1-1.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. Wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
Here's a 1-1. Runner on the go. Strike in there. And that's a stolen base, not even close.
Well, he picked over once just before the pitch to check on him, but that didn't seem to slow up his jump on the pitch at all. I think that guy's been studying some video. Awesome job to be prepared, got the timing down, and gets into scoring position.
And it's second. Next offering is outside. On the ground. Rojas throws on to first. Two down.
Now batting, catcher, Travis Darno.
And now it's Atlanta's cleanup hitter, Travis Darno. That one's in there, 0-1.
0-1.
The next pitch misses, and it's a ball and a strike. Acuna on its second with two down. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Travis Darno hits one out. His first homer of the year. It's 9-9.
He was looking for, crushes it, and hits it out of the ballpark.
Two outs, nobody on. Here's Matt Olson.
Now back, the first baseman.
Man. And that's in there for strike one.
Olson.
Offering misses, and the count is 1-1. The wind and the pitch, and now 2-1. Left-hand hitter waits, and there's a ball.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
And there's ball four.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Now back.
Two outs, runner at first. Marcelo Zuna next up for the Braves.
Zuna.
That one lifted to left. Peralta under this one. Drops into the glove, and the inning is over. Just one hit in the inning, but it was a big one right here as it ties the ball game. And we've got a good one. Tied at 9-9.
Look at me. Not measuring up how I want to be. Pleased with small things.
Jesse Chavez comes on now. Hasn't pitched in a while. He's had the last 5 days off.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
We go to the top of the fifth, and now Carson Kelly. And a pitch. That misses. 1-0. Good eye right there. Righty to the plate. In the air, right field, pretty well struck. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Well, that one ended up a lot closer to home run than I thought off the bat. Clearly didn't get it all. But with that wind blowing out to right, almost pushed that one over the wall.
Geraldo Perdomo stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Swing and a ball popped up. Rosario makes his way towards it. Nice grab on the run. And a couple of quick outs.
Up next to the Diamondback, the third baseman, Josh.
So the lineup flips over. Now the third baseman, Josh Rojas, 1-for-3. In there, and it's 0-1.
All ones to count.
Yoan. Now 1-1. The 1-1. He swings and fouls one off. Ground ball to the right side. Out number 3. Diamondbacks down quickly, and our score remains tied at 9 apiece. The pitcher on here, Kyle Nelson. This southpaw has been really good against left-handed hitters.
Kyle Nelson.
Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Stepping in, Eddie Rosario.
No left fielder.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
Drilled in the air, right field, way back there, and that is out of here. That was a moonshot. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. It's 10-9. Rush. Orlando Arcia, next up for the Braves.
Now batting, the second baseman.
In there for strike one.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
And the 0-1. That misses off the outside edge. The Diamondbacks with some movement in the pen. Noé Ramirez appears to be getting loose. Kennedy getting loose as well. Next pitch misses, and that's ball two. Kicks and deals. Slice down the right side. The pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Here's the 2-2. This one blasted deep to left, way out of here, home run. He circles the bases, his first homer of the year, and they add a run, it's 11-9.
Ball on the inside part of the plate requires a hitter to stay really square with his mechanics. If you fly open with the left shoulder, there's no way you keep that ball fair. An outstanding job mechanically. He deserves that home run.
Now, Michael Harris.
Now back, the center fielder. Michael.
Swing and a high fly ball to left. Peralta gliding back. Calls it in for the out.
The right fielder, number 13, Ronald Acuna.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Here's Ronald Acuna Jr. at the plate for the fourth time tonight. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Offering his foul back. And a pitch. The punch out there. Two away. So two down now. And here is Dansby Swanson.
Dansby.
Good contact guy, good defender.
Swanson.
Next offering is down low, and that is ball one. The wide to kick the pitch. And another ball. And the slider just misses.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it, so that's a good take by him.
The pitch. There's a strike. Two outs. That's a strike. Full count now.
Three balls, two strikes.
The wind of the pitch. Out to short. Dives, and he can't hang on. He doesn't have a play, and he reaches safely.
Now batting.
Runner at first with two away. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Austin Riley. He's already homered here in this one. Swanson off of first with two away.
Let's go, Braves.
Next offering is down low. Nelson over to first. Swanson dives back in safely. And here comes the pitch. There goes the runner from first, and it's safe. It's a stolen base.
Well, that steal right there is wanting to take advantage of having a really good hitter at the plate. Now they've got a much better shot at bringing home a two-out RBI.
The 2-1. Hey. And a foul ball. Kicks and fires. Right side, hard hit. And that's just foul. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Good job at damage control right there. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. We're through five. You're dialed into the show. Top of the sixth inning. Now it's the right fielder, Alec Thomas.
Leading off for Arizona, the right fielder, number five, Alec
Chavez. Back to work. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. And the 0-1. Swing and a base hit.
The batter, the second baseman.
So up next, Ketel Marte. He's already homered in this game. First offering, and it just misses.
Now, this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Next offering is in for a strike.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
Next pitch is downstairs. Runner at first with no outs here. Now this one is hammered way back there. On its way and gone. And we are tied. Ketel Marte leaves the yard. His second of the year. And we are starting over. It's 11-11.
Really great job of anticipation there. He knows he throws the sinker. That one down in the zone. You're trying to beat it to the spot it's getting to. Well, he won.
Here's the cleanup hitter for the Diamondbacks, Christian Walker.
Now back, the first baseman, Christian Walker.
First pitch just misses. This ball is hammered deep center field, way back there, on its way, out of here. They do it again, back-to-back homers, and that gives them a lead. It's 12-11.
Well, he put a really nice swing on that one, and everything was on time, took a direct path to the ball, excellent extension, and just drove it out of here. Nothing better than when the ball jumps off your bat like that.
Tyler Matzik will take over on the mound. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Tyler Matzik. 6.
Now the left fielder, David Peralta.
Now batting, left fielder, David Peralta.
And that one hammered. That's back. And it's gone. Home run. His first homer of the year, and they tack on to their lead. It's 13-11.
Back to back to back home runs, and these guys look so dominant right now. Pitcher might want to check and see if he's tipping his pitches or not, but I tell you what, if this was basketball, that opposing team would call a timeout to try to slow down this offense.
Dalton Varsho stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Now that designated hitter, Dalton Varsho.
Pitch misses inside, and that's ball one.
Hey, partner, how's your scorecard looking right now?
A little dicey. Kind of hieroglyphics style at the moment. You know what it's like, Singy? Remember our trip to London, Yankees and Red Sox in 2019? I think there were, 50 runs scored in the two games combined. My scorecard was ugly for that series. And it's 1-1.
Wow. Good luck catching up to that one.
The lefty ready and a 1-1. Yeah. Next offering misses down and away.
Yeah, pretty ridiculous. And you use like 5 different colors of pens, so like it's just a mosaic over there.
Yeah, I mean, I know you're always judging the different pens. Like, you know, I got the skinny scoring pen, and then I have the red, and then the black, and then I got a highlighter. So there is a lot going on. The pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. And down on strikes he goes, and now one away. Next to hit for Arizona, Jake McCarthy.
Jake McCarthy.
Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone. His first homer of the year, and they add to their lead. It's 14-11.
Power versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's going to win? Well, a really good job there by the hitter getting the top hand working. How is that fastball out of here?
Now it's going to be Carson Kelly.
Now batting, catcher, Carson Kelly.
First pitch, and he just misses. This one blasted the other way, down the line, and it's a foul ball.
There's a guy right there that really trusts his hands. I mean, you have to wait a little bit longer with the breaking ball. He did that, and he still had the power to drive it the other way. Just couldn't keep it fair.
Next pitch is popped up. Riley under it. Pulls it down, and there's two gone.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Geraldo Perdomo.
Next up for the Diamondbacks, Geraldo Perdomo. And that's in there for strike one. 0-2 now. Popped up. And that's the third out. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. Arizona's on top, 14-11. Noe Ramirez on a pitch out of the pen here. Trying to protect this lead.
Number 24, Noe Ramirez.
Now the catcher up to hit, Travis d'Arnaud.
Leading off for the Braves, the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud.
The pitch. And that misses off the outside edge.
Looking to get something going, this is the guy you want at the plate. He's been great for this team. He is a professional hitter.
Righty delivers. In the air on the infield. Walker moving under this one. And he makes the catch. One up, one down.
Well, that's a frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter right there. I mean, that pitch was right down the middle. I think he got a little too excited, came out of his mechanics. And instead of driving that ball somewhere, he popped it up. Unfortunate for him.
Matt Olson up to the plate. We all just played the lotto, but the numbers never ride, and I'm tired of it. In there, and it's 0-1. Next offering is in for a strike. Oh, and two now. And now one and two. One and two now. Way inside, and that hit him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
Well, it definitely didn't come out of his hand the way that he was intending it to, and the release point was a little bit off as well.
Ozuna, batting with one down, takes a strike. Olson leads off first with one away. Right side. Oh, nice stop at first. Quickly to second for one. And it's a double play to end the inning. Seventh inning coming up. D-backs out in front, 14-11. At the bullpen is Will Smith. He's been so good against lefties.
Number 51. Will.
And welcome back. Here's the third baseman, Josh Rojas.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, the third baseman, Josh Rojas.
The pitch. And fouled off. Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. And down on strikes. And there's one away. Now up next for Arizona, Alec Thomas. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. And first offering is fouled off. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss. And the count is 0-2. Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2 stays alive. Next one misses, and a count 1-2. And that's down and away. The 2-2. Up the middle. He dives, but he can't make the catch. Not in time. Great effort, but it's an infield hit.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Marte in now, takes ball one off the plate.
Run,
to first, and he breaks for second. To second, and he's out. Out front and foul to the left side. Here's a 1-1. Late swing, fouled off.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
Next offering is fouled back. Right side, Arcia over to pick it up. Third out.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Back here in Atlanta, set for the last half of the seventh. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Eddie Rosario.
The left fielder, Eddie Rosario.
The right-hander back to work. And ball one. Activity in the Arizona bullpen. Luke Weaver up and loosening in the pen. Mantiply, the lefty, warming up as well.
Get out of here.
Right-handed reliever. That catches the top part of the zone. That's strike one. Next offering down low and in the dirt. Next one off the plate inside. Ball three. And the righty deals. Swing and a ball hammered left field. Way back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. A solo shot. His third home run of the game, and they inch closer. It's 14-12.
Show at the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with this swing, and he's just not missing right now. Maybe three homer game, and so special. And I tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching him pull it off as well.
Out of the bullpen and into the game is Ian Kennedy. This is his first appearance of the season. So digging in, Orlando Arcia.
The batter, the second baseman, Orlando Arcia.
That one's in there, 0-1. And the right-hander deals. That one pushed foul. That misses the zone. Now 1-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. Upstairs. And a 2-2.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
On the ground to short. And one away in the bottom of the seventh.
Now batting, center fielder, Michael Harris.
And stepping in is the speedy Michael Harris. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. And first offering is fouled off. Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. That one misses. And a count 1-2. Left hand batter waits. Bumgarner into the outfield for a knock.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Just kept it simple, played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Man at first with one gone, and here is Ronald Acuna Jr. Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. It's in the dirt. Throw to second. Great jump. And that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close. Check on the runner. Harris back in on a dive. Next pitch is inside, ball two.
Yeah, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone. His first homer of the year, and we are all tied up. It's 14 apiece.
Always scary for a pitcher when a guy can take a fastball down the middle and hit it to the opposite field. No holes in a swing like that. And that time, that ball just hit hard.
And here is Dansby Swanson.
Up next for Atlanta, the shortstop, Dansby Swanson.
Slapped foul.
Let's do it, Atlanta!
and a pitch. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Now hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Luke Weaver taking over on the mound, and this is his season debut. One down, runner at first. And now, Austin Riley. Gotta be careful with this guy. He's got power. He can untie it with one swing. In there for strike one. Throw to first, and he's back in safely. Offering misses, a ball, one strike. One away, tie game. Go ahead run stands at first. Next offering is in for a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
Righty to the plate. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Line drive. McCarthy makes the play. And there's two away.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time off, he'll find a hole.
Now the Atlanta cleanup hitter, Travis d'Arnaud.
Your base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get in the scoring position. Some guys are just more confident. They can track that first pitch out of the hand of the pitcher. They don't care if they fall behind 0-1.
Two outs.
One and one.
Weaver checks on first. Swanson back on a dive. Another throw over. And he's back again. And a pitch. Runner on the goal. Pitch in for a strike. Throw there. Safe.
Well, he came back to defense for not paying enough attention. They threw over a few times, but he just waited it out, kept his timing. He was able to swipe the bag. Nice job of base running right there.
Swing by d'Arnaud. That one lifted to left. High and deep. Out of here. That's gotta feel good. And just like that, they're out front. It's 16-14.
Excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
And now Matt Olson up to hit.
Up next for Atlanta, the first baseman.
And that's in there for strike one.
Olson.
0-1 down. Good eye in that spot.
1-1.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. That one's carrying. And it hits the top of the wall. Oh, the throw is wild. So here's the Braves' designated hitter, Marcell Ozuna.
Now that the designated hitter.
That's pitched downstairs. Ball one. Kicks and deals. And it's even up. Runner at third, two away. Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch stays alive. Pitch. Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. Another homer, his second home run of the game, and they boost their lead. It's 18-14.
Especially with good velocity, can be really hard to catch up to. But he stays tall, his top hand works extremely well, and he absolutely clobbered it.
Joe Mantiply will take over here. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Well, I think that what makes him so tough against left-handers is he hides the ball for a long time. And from that same side, harder for you to determine which part of the plate it's going to end up on.
Eddie Rosario next up for the Braves.
Now batting, the left fielder, Eddie.
First offering misses the mark. The lefty, the 1-0. That's down and in. Left-hand hitter waits. Strike two.
Two balls, two strikes.
And that's downstairs and outside. And now the lefty fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Right through there, got him. That's the inning. The final damage here, they bat around. 10 come to the plate, 7 runs on the board. Eighth inning coming up. Braves lead this one 18-14. Here comes A.J. Minter to the mound. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. Back at Truist Park, and now the first baseman, Christian Walker.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, the first baseman, Christian Walker.
The pitch. check swing, but he went too far. And it's 0-1. Minter, a very difficult guy to get hits off of. It's really rare for teams to string stuff together against it.
He wins every pitch. And for a hitter, sometimes a victory is just fouling off one of his pitches.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Unless he beats himself, somehow can't find it, doesn't have the control and command that day, you can pretty much forget about it.
The pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. As a hitter, there's even more pressure to take advantage of any mistake, right?
Yeah, and you're hoping that, you know, somehow, some way, whether it's a hit by pitch, a walk, something bad happens, because outside of that, stuff is just too good to fail.
Kicks and fires. Stays alive.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
The pitch. Swung on. Popped up on the infield. Olsen makes the catch. And there's one down.
And he's got deception in his delivery. And it's not that he's trying to deceive the hitters. He just has this natural flow that makes it hard for hitters to pick the ball up. It gets on them a little bit quicker than they anticipate, even though they know what the velocity numbers are.
Peralta, the next to hit, takes ball one. Bullpen activity starting up now. Colin McHugh getting ready to come in for manager Brian Snitker. In for a strike. Strike one. That one the other way. He's got it. There's two away.
Now batting the designated hitter, Dalton Varsho.
So next is the designated hitter for the D-backs, Dalton Varsho. And the first pitch misses for ball one. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Next offering upstairs.
Two ball, one strike.
And here it comes. That's inside. 3-1. And he deals. Pulled hard, but it's a foul ball. And the pitch. Swing and a slow roller. Throw on to Olsen, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Welcome back. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Now it's the second baseman, Orlando Arcia.
The second baseman, Orlando Arcia.
Here comes a pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Activity in the bullpen. Mark Melanson getting ready to go. Next offering is in for a strike. Good, that one down the line, and it goes just foul. And a pitch.
Well, he might have to look for a different put away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Kicks and deals. And there's a ball. And a pitch. Ripped on a line. McCarthy makes the grab, and there's one down.
Man, that's one of those at bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it, but in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at bat.
Harris at the plate and takes high there. The 1-0.
I got a ball, one strike.
Swings through that one for strike two.
One and two.
Left-hand batter waits. That one just misses.
That's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Comes the 2-2. That one missed. Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
Hopefully he figures it out on the mound because they're running out of arms in that bullpen.
Back to the top of the order at the plate. Ronald Acuna Jr., not your prototypical leadoff guy, gets on base, yes, but also some power. Moved first. Harris back easily. Runner on the move, pitches low, throw to second, and he's out.
That goes to show you stealing a base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big-time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw, quick, not rushed, and accurate.
And a pitch. Fought off foul. Two down, nobody on. And downstairs. Chop to the left side. And he picks it up in foul territory. Here's a 2-2. And now it's filled up. That home run was a no doubt as we dive into the numbers with Statcast.
Crushed. Just absolutely crushed. 112 miles per hour on the exit velo, and
Like you said, no doubt about that one. Plenty of launch angle to give it that backspin as well, and that carried way over the wall.
Dansby Swanson is going to get a chance to hit. A guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also on the field. The pitch. That one off the mark, and now 2-0. The 2-0 is in for a strike. And a rope into center field, base hit. And that means Austin Riley will have a chance to hit.
Now batting.
And next for Atlanta, Austin Riley. Good power, not great in the OBP department. Here goes the runner. Pitch inside. Throw to second. Out there. And that ends the inning. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. Last chance coming up for the D-backs. Pitching change here, Colin McHugh. And he'll try to keep this big lead right where it is.
Colin McHugh.
We go to the ninth. Here's a speed threat, Jake McCarthy.
Leading off for Arizona, the center fielder, Jake McCarthy.
The wind of the pitch. Oh, he gloves it.
That's what you got to have at the hot corner. Cat-like reflexes, line drive, caught by the third baseman as he dives. Terrific play.
Carson Kelly stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Lifted in the air, right center field. Acuna headed to the alley. Makes the grab on the run. And there are two down.
The batter, number two, shortstop, Geraldo.
Two outs, bases Perdomo. Empty. Geraldo Perdomo now at the plate. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Movement in the Atlanta bullpen. Dylan Lee, the left-hander, up and throwing. Just one out away. Try to close it out. Bunt attempt, but that goes foul. Oh, and two down. The other way. And that's a base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Now batting. Third baseman.
Down the third baseman, Josh Rojas. Pitch misses inside. And that's ball one. Right-handed reliever. Line drive, base hit. So that's two straight, two out hits. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Alec
Thomas stands in now for the Diamondbacks. That one's in there, 0-1. Perdomo at second, Rojas at first, two out of the inning. The next offering misses, 1-1.
Yeah, he can move the ball around, add and subtract, get some weak contact at times. So you don't worry as much about him in this situation. Very capable of getting a ground ball and getting out of this little jam.
Yeah. Base hit, left center field. Perdomo coming home, and that's going to roll to the wall. One run is in. Rojas around third. He's in there.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Kenley Jansen into the game. A runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there.
Kenley Jansen.
Ketel Marte will hit next. Check swing, but he went too far. Strike one. And the righty deals. And now the count is even. And it's second. Just missed. Two outs and one in scoring position. Next pitch is outside.
Pressure mountain right here with the tying run and the on deck circle. He's got to find the strike zone.
Righty to the plate. To the right side. Tries to reach for it, but it's through. Three, two. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Just one strike away. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Up next,
first and second, two down. Here's a big power threat. Christian Walker. In there, and it's 0-1. As he waves at that one. Jansen. He's kind of a prototypical bullpen arm in today's game. Electric stuff that results in a ton of strikeouts in a tough spot like this. That is a big time benefit. That one fouled off.
Now, as a hitter, when a guy like this comes into the game, you feel like he's standing on top of you, and it's just attack mode coming right at you, expecting to get a swing and miss.
And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
So this is flat out an incredible comeback. I'm almost speechless. These guys showed patience, they grinded out the at-bats, and had quality at-bats, did exactly what they needed to climb back in a ball game with this kind of deficit. Excellent job to get the W today.
High-scoring ball game in this one. Kenley Jansen picking up the save. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
His record is now 1-0. Credit the save to Kenley Jansen, his first. The loss goes to Ian Kennedy. He falls to 0-1. Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 29 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Truist Park, 41,500. The Braves thank you for your continued support and remind you to please drive home safely.